señores. We are the cast of Gentefied. And by now, I hope you've watched all 10 episodes of season one.
Because we're here to spill and chisme from behind the scenes.
Yay, yay.
Yes, but there are hella spoilers, okay? So if you haven't watched the season yet, pause this, go watch that, come back on this, you can get out on top of it.
Yeah. All right, but let's go into the questions right here. We got them ready to go.
I got a galletita.
No hay galletas. There's never cookies in these things. So
no, true. I just always want to ask.
Oh, wait.
Spill it. They say spill it. They don't really
eat it. Here we go. Okay, first question. Who took the longest in the HMU trailer, otherwise known as a hair makeup trailer?
I think it was me.
I would say Karrie.
Yeah, because I had to get there like 2 hours before I started every morning.
They did your hair.
Yeah.
Yeah.
As you can see, I don't have long hair.
How long did it take you today?
Less than an hour.
Oh, God.
Less than an hour.
Improvements have been made.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Go ahead.
What are you?
Dale.
I'm excited.
I can't.
What was one of the most memorable moments on set? Carlos's ass.
Yeah. Moment of that was we're standing there and every one of us, because we all showed up. Do you guys remember?
Yeah, I remember. You guys were supposed to be there, but you still came. That was great.
Group chat. I remember texting Julissa. I was like, girl, when are you off? She's like, I'm going to be off at 4. I'm like, okay, I'm going to get there. She's like, get here soon because Carlos is seen.
It's the rave that we went to that I take him to.
Episode 4, the rave scene.
We're all there. We're all waiting there, dying laughing because.
What we knew how like shy and like embarrassed he was about this. Yeah. So we all decided to show up.
Yeah, because you guys support me every way I step.
We support your cheeks
wherever
you.
They go.
What was the best part
about it? The best part about it was we're sitting there behind the camera. We can watch on the monitors, right? In Video Village. And someone is, because Carlos, his whole booty's out.
So,
and he has a sock around his, right? So he's up there, he's climbing up, and congratulations, Carlos.
Thank you.
Because he's standing like this with his booty out, and you see the cock sock hanging right here. I'm dying laughing. All of a sudden, we hear them, America yelling, cover your penis. And he's like, what? I don't hear you.
No, first she said, cover the sock.
Cover the sock. And then she yells, cover your penis. And then all the extras, because he's like, what? I can't hear you. Cover your penis.
I didn't hear what she was saying. You know you have those dreams where you think you're naked? I literally lived it.
Oh my God.
I had 100 people yelling at me, cover my penis. And I'll never forget it.
And we will neither. Oh, we enjoyed it.
You know.
Yay.
Oh,
all right. Gracias, Julissa.
De nada.
Did you eat any of the food on set, off set?
Oh my God.
I didn't
have any food.
What?
Me neither.
No, I ate every episode.
I think you
when we were in the kitchen, all the food that you see in the kitchen
is real.
It's not fake food. But when we were working there, they restocked it every morning with legit everything. So we were in between. I was eating chips. I was eating all of
the chips. I was making tacos with the refried beans. I didn't know that they had a spit bucket. Didn't know this until like episode 3. They were like, Karrie, by the way, you don't have to eat that. And I was like, I have been stuffing my face.
I will commit.
For days.
For real.
For days.
What a festival.
I mean, I did that.
What a commitment.
And I was also at Crafty all the time.
I'm like
a crafty, like.
Forget you.
Yeah, get out of here, Karrie.
Shut up, Karrie. And me and Julissa decided to do a cleanse before this shoot. So get the hell out of here, girl.
On set, we look at it, we sniff it.
Yo,
we eat an apple.
No, we would legit get these cookies that they had on set, and I'd be like, Julissa, we can't have a bite. She's like, no. And I'm like, come on. And she goes, let me smell it.
And then I get the dessert, and they'd all be like, can I have a bite of that? You're gonna share with me?
That was me. I would always be like, I just want a bite of what you get. And then I'd come in right when Julissa would come in right when I was taking the bite, and she'd be like, Anigonio.
I will say that I did know about the spit bucket, but because I'm a professional. I ate it all. We had the hot dog scene, and we had the.
I didn't. Wait, the scene
with the tamales.
The scene with the tamales and the hot dog scene happened.
Two days apart.
So in 3 days, I ate like 8 tamales in one sitting.
Yeah.
And I think I ate like 10 hot dogs. And every time I was like, hit me. And the guy was like, are you okay? You shouldn't be doing this.
That's
I was like, come on, give me a. And it hurt. I was saturated by sodium. I don't think you should do it. Looking back, I think the lesson learned.
You should be like
spit it.
Bucket,
spit
yeah.
it.
Who ate the most tamales in that scene?
I think Carlos. I did. Cause I get
in episode one.
Yeah.
If you look, I was nibbling it. I'd be like, oh, good.
Yeah.
But
no,
I was not trying to eat.
It was him. And then like we like ran out.
Oh yeah.
We ran out.
Because that was the end of the night, and we had to, like,
yeah. I ran out of them because you kept eating them. Yeah,
I feel like I should have ate the most food. I was pregnant. You know what? Lydia ain't pregnant this next season, so they got it. I want to hang out with you.
Let's keep
okay,
going.
Next.
What we got here? Whose trailer was always popping?
Not yours.
I would beg to differ. I mean,
you didn't want anybody in your trailer.
No, but...
Yes.
It was this a very exclusive
remember
party.
Remember when we went over to sing? Didn't we go to him over one time?
I'd party at Daddy's trailer.
No, she did.
No.
She did.
It was the day of your very, very serious
yeah.
Oh, and you guys wanted to come over and...
And I didn't realize that you were just so, like, in your zone.
Yeah. I was so involved.
Yeah.
And,
like, you weren't answering my text, and I was really annoyed. I was like, he's right next door. Why isn't he answering my text? And I was like, you know, hey, JJ, how are you? Like, you weren't even communicating with me. I was, like, a little butthurt, I think. And so, like, we all, like, decided to, like, bombard your trailer that day, and we opened it, and it was so depressing.
We all were like...
With the music and everything.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And he was like, hi, guys. I was like, oh.
Yeah.
Actually, no, it was more like, you guys, I opened the thing, and my eyes were watery, and you guys were like...
We went over to sing to you. We sang while you were in tears. So we're like, oh, we're messing up halfway through the song.
Oh, wait, yes.
That's what it was.
Yeah, okay, but what scene? Tell them what
tell
scene.
Tell them the scene.
I don't remember.
Hey, JJ, tell them the scene.
I remember.
Okay, tell them.
It was the scene that you had told me, or I had, you know, you told me, like, yo, we can't do this no more, and then you were going to go to pop.
Yeah.
That was that scene.
Yeah.
And so especially when I walked up, he looked at me, and then I was like, oh, I don't think I should be here. I think I'm a trigger. And then,
woo. Well, you were giving back the ring. That's what it was. It's a heavy scene.
Or was it happy
so if y'all saw that scene, it's beautiful.
It's beautiful.
And it was all real.
Yeah.
Well, so
yeah.
Does that mean that his trailer was popping?
No.
It was, yes.
No, that
because
was.
I feel like Carlos's trailer was
yes.
popping.
Yes! No, wait.
Because.
I feel like the HMU trailer was popping.
Wait, wait, no. Hold up. No,
oh,
wait.
Yeah,
we're talking
about
real trailers. It was the HMU trailer makeup.
Absolutely. Hair and makeup.
Trailer.
I always have my music going. What are you talking about?
For you.
I invited to the party.
I invited.
JJ, nobody went to your trailer, so who was listening to that music?
It was me.
Okay, well, maybe Jay was popping,
but
us three over here.
Yeah.
Hair and makeup was popping, but I would also say if we're gonna choose from us, Carlos was always getting pranked.
Yes!
So, and one day his trailer got TP'd.
Yeah. Not TP'd, newspaper
news. Newspaper,
ridiculous. This is getting really ridiculous. What the come on. Has the time for, what is the?
One time he got scared because someone was hiding in the bathroom.
can I tell you?
You took a what?
You didn't.
As a kid, I had to go to the bathroom. And I was like, I didn't feel like walking all the way to the studio bathrooms. And I was like, Karrie, Joaquin, JJ.
Oh my God, I was abused.
Appropriate. Who pulled the most pranks?
Oh boy.
Hair and makeup.
I just scared people.
Why do you do that?
I love it.
I hate it so much. You guys are always.
Wait, hold on a minute.
Oh.
Did y'all get scared? Was it you?
Oh yeah.
Who would carry around a little dinosaur?
Okay. So not the dinosaur. So I have a thing that sounds like a panther. You guys remember that? It has thing that when you blow on it goes.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
But did you do it to everybody else?
But I scared the crap out of you, and we have video of it. And at some point,
and you didn't do it to anybody else.
Well, we tried, but it was hard because it wasn't as loud.
Hey y'all, I'm Karrie Martin.
You just got jaguared.
I hate you. Get out of my video.
All right, my turn.
You're looking.
Here's the question. What is one time that really made you cry?
You can pick.
Yeah.
Okay, Offset, Julissa and I had seen our younger versions with like their name tags. Like it said like Anna and Jessica. And we were like, we want this too. Like, why did they get, like, we were like little kids, like whining about it.
Oh, and I know this story.
Then Marvin.
Marvin, the creator, co-creator.
And we mentioned Linda. Linda,
Marvin and Linda, they're co-creators. They are fire, they are writers, they are amazing.
The fool that he is comes into our trailer, and that day was our breakup scene. So we hadn't spoken all day, and I was like, why is this girl not talking to me?
She's so mad about it right now.
I am a little. So Marvin comes in. What did he tell us? He was like, we need to tell y'all something.
Yeah, but it was very serious, and we obviously we have all this tension this day.
So much emotion.
So we all look, and we're like, what's up? And he's like, he breaks out.
He gifts us our name necklaces, and we're like, why? We were like whining about this. Like, it was actually really emotional.
It was the whole trailer, I feel like, went silent.
Yeah.
And we just, all you heard was me and Karrie.
And then
just
I remember
crying.
Linda being like, I can't believe you did it like that. That's not how it was supposed to, you know, like just yelling at
Marvin
him.
Doesn't know.
But he was like, I'm so sorry. Like, I think he felt bad because I don't think he expected us to cry.
Mm-hmm.
But I think that whole day, in my personal opinion, was like the heaviest day.
Karrie, Julissa?
Yeah.
Can
you come here?
Put your phone down. We just have something that we need to give you guys. This is something that's really important, and I'm just hopefully this is not a problem. But we just wanted to make sure that you guys have this for your next scene.
Actually, gifts for you guys. So.
Thank you.
Oh my God.
I know. I was like, why did you?
I think the most emotional was when we did the first thing we did before we started, when we did the breathing exercises, when we got together in the space.
Yes.
So we did like a thing before we even started shooting. It was like with America
meditative
and everybody else,
experience.
Like a meditative
Joaquin.
Experience to kind of, I guess, touch base with everybody and to connect with the space and the set, because we were in the middle, we were in the house.
Mm-hmm.
And then Julissa fell asleep.
We're talking about crying.
Oh, okay.
No,
that's for the next question.
Involved.
Who fell asleep during a meditative? Anyway, no.
Yes.
But I blew you
I
up.
Think that's okay. I think
no, that's
it's
fine,
because
that's
I was
you
that
you were
calm.
Serene.
No, that's fine, that's fine.
You were deep in it. You were so deep in it.
I think that was like the first time that I started talking about things, and it just like it just came out of me. Like I started crying.
We cried a lot.
And I wasn't expecting it.
And we didn't know each other really, and everyone cried.
We all cried.
And I was like, God damn it, they saw me vulnerable.
Yeah.
Yeah,
that's nice.
Who was the most method actor? Oh my God, could we all say it in one, at the same time? Ready?
One, two, three.
JJ!
What can I say?
JJ was the most method, right? But then like at times, like, yo, it's hilarious because he had to be all loving and stuff with me. And they'd be like, a little more. And he'd be like, that's not loving, I'm being loving. So me and JJ, he's supposed to be taking care of me, right, before I'm gonna give birth. And so I was like, you gotta do something nice for me. And he's like, what do you want? And I'm like, I don't know, like, I'm gonna go over to your house and you're gonna make me a sandwich. And he's like, okay. So I go over and he's like, just so you know, because you'll appreciate this. He's like, I went and bought the bread, I got this all special, da da da. And it's all set up, right, the sandwich is there on the table with the milk. And I was like, you're not gonna eat with me? He's like, damn, girl, I already made you the sandwich.
Hey, baby steps.
I was like, okay, yeah, thank you so much, honey.
Hey, but you have to understand, I was in aisle four.
Baby,
I was in aisle four looking at the fucking jellies, and I was like, okay, which is she likes, grape or strawberry? Which one's gonna be? And I was really taking time
so
and effort.
So intricate. Yeah.
It was detailed.
Wow, JJ, round of applause for you.
Mira, es method hasta para sandwich making.
Peanut butter and jelly sandwich, y'all.
But that was special.
But I would say that I remember you being like, man, he's so nice to y'all. Do you remember that?
No, yeah.
And he always was like very like,
he would be, because he would
that's
be.
That's the method, right?
Yes. He would be so loving offset. He'd be so like loving and affectionate to everyone. But some reason for me, I think because he was trying to be in it with like Lydia and not Annie, I'd get like a little bit of the cold shoulder. Not the cold shoulder, but just he'd be a little more like here, right? And it wasn't until we stopped shooting that he'd be like, come here, girl. And I'm like, this is okay.
I thought, but then,
I'd be like, so like he hugs you guys? And I'm like, yeah, like, I don't know, he doesn't really hug me.
What was one of the biggest secrets you kept while shooting?
I think it was one of the hardest is you guys, right?
Yeah. Not being able to say anything.
Not posting on Instagram.
I remember Julissa posting something and changing the timbre of her voice to fake it.
Yes! Oh my God, JJ, look at you. I'm not Julissa, I'm just this person.
When I would record behind the cameras.
How many times did we have like things taken down?
Yeah. Like we were never able to take pictures together.
Right.
It was like, we built
can you please take this town in the nicest way possible, but I know she was yelling.
Like these motherfuckers. I know. Didn't we tell them already? Yeah. We'd be like, well, we just want to pose and celebrate.
We were just excited to be together. Mm-hmm.
That's for real.
But then when we were able to talk about it, it was awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Dale.
Pick it.
Yeah, JJ, you're reading over there.
Look what I got. How was it the first day of shooting?
First day.
We were all there the first day.
The best.
I think it was very nerve-wracking. It was light for me, so I feel like I didn't really feel the pressure or the stress because I only had the bar, that scene right there.
That we were all in.
Yeah. And we were doing karaoke. That was tough for you because you were sweating bullets.
Oh! Also,
in Spanish?
Yeah. It was like a very, like, y'all were like arguing in that scene as well. Yeah. So like he comes in like in a very different mood than we were in.
Mm. Yeah. I remember being like, damn, this guy's an asshole a little bit. Not gonna lie. Cause he was in his method again.
Yeah.
But also too, because like we haven't worked together, so I didn't know like the energy, anything. Obviously, this is our characters, right? We do not get along.
Right.
But I'm like, damn, he could be
a jerk.
Like Julissa got like her feelings got a little bit. Damn, I'm like, but Jessica wanted to be like, bruh. I will pop you in your shit right now.
Just like that.
But it was fun.
It was.
How'd you feel about it?
I was all in my feelings. I was all in that space. And I felt right. It felt like it was how it should have felt. Mm-hmm. And because I felt disconnected from you guys, but at the same time. So I was like, as much as I wanted to be a part of the camaraderie, I knew that this is where I needed to be at that moment.
It was interesting, right? Because we're like in a little tiff and you guys are having a great time. And then I feel like the last day kind of wraps, not in a tiff, but
we end just up, as emotional.
But just as emotional with a bunch of different things. That's when we had our daughter.
Yeah.
Aww.
That baby, that really.
Well, I didn't do that.
That was a hard scene.
Yeah.
Damn, I missed it.
Wait, my favorite part about that was Carlos. So like I'm giving childbirth, right? So I'm like crying and in it, and Carlos kept coming up to me. I want to smack the fuck out of you. Kept coming up to me. He's like, it's okay, you're acting. And I was like, I know.
Why did you do that?
You kept saying like, it's okay, stop crying.
It was Marvin.
You kept trying to pacify me from crying and you're like, stop, it's okay. And I was like, no, I need to stay in this. And after he goes, wow, I didn't know that you could do this. Like, you were like shocked. I remember that was me and not Marvin.
Damn. I think it was Marvin. Would Marvin look a lot different? I would never.
I mean, hello.
I would never mess with your process.
I promise you were you because I was like,
maybe it was that Carlos.
But you would poke fun at the appropriate time.
You, this is who you are.
That's my method, guys.
Yeah.
Was it hard to keep your dietas?
Oh.
I was never on a diet, guys.
Dieta.
I mean.
And I didn't even work out. JJ, let me tell y'all something. Let me tell y'all something though. This is like a new thing that I have. I do work out now.
Do you?
You work out now?
I do.
When?
Y'all, in the last like few months since I've, you know, been back in Louisiana, but JJ here.
Oh, man.
Let's talk about your dietas. Cause he would bring food.
I
wouldn't even eat on set with us.
The most beautiful thing about Crafty. You know how easy it is to get used to Crafty?
I would come on days I wasn't working to get Crafty. Like, I'd be like, what time's lunch? 2? Be right there. I bring a box to go. Like, thank you guys. You can throw it away. I got you.
Yeah.
It'd be hard on set, though, too, because with all the meat and everything.
Yeah. And then on the days that they always brought, like, on Fridays when they would bring food trucks and stuff, the day that I wanted ice cream and JJ was looking at me, he's like, don't do it. And Carlos is like, just a little bit.
Remember when we were shooting in the park and it's the week I was shooting the butt stuff. Uh-huh. That's weird. Let me rephrase it.
The butt stuff?
That's not right. The
nalgas.
The nalga scene. I wasn't eating and they had some bomb dessert. And remember, we packed it.
Oh my gosh,
I'm gonna pack this and eat it after.
It was bread pudding.
Thank you.
So and they said that they were gonna bring it back the last day. And they didn't.
He looked at me in the eyes and said, yeah, no, I'll bring it back. He didn't.
He didn't.
He did that really good chocolate chip cookie thing.
It wasn't the same, but I never got to taste it.
I gotta say, I had a conflicting moment though when Marvin told me He goes, you gotta eat. I gotta write more stuff where you eat. And I was conflicted because I was like, JJ don't want to eat no more.
Yeah.
But it was right. He was right. It fit.
But Eric wanted to eat.
Yeah.
I love the third person, JJ.
Yeah, the eating scene's very
great.
Well, it looks like that's all the questions we have. So if you haven't seen Gentefied, tune in and tell your friends.
Tune in, hey. Tune in. We out. See you guys season 2.